All right, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Real Stock Show. NASDAQ up about 0.4%. Got Tesla in my ear right here. AVR 12%. That's our buddy. Beyond Meat, Soxel up here. RH, AMD, Okta. See what's down here. Not much. Kind of a lazy open. Except for D-Dog. D-Dog had earnings, if I'm not mistaken, gapping up 10%, even after all that run-up. Look at that. That's pretty spectacular. We'll see if they keep going. How close are we to the highs of the NASDAQ? We gotta be within a stone's throw. Look at that. Like 2 or 3%. 3.5%. 3.5% to the NASDAQ. D-Dog 14% now. Running this morning. That thing's gonna go. Maybe another 20% day for D-Dog. 15%. Tesla Soxel up there. Okay. I don't know what IVR is doing up so much there. Wow, pretty lazy day. Good, decent amount of upside action, but nothing extraordinarily bullish. Ended up yesterday doing pretty good. A little sell-off at the end of the day again. We are expanding those Bollinger Bands again, though. And an elevated volume day to boot. They're just slowly walking up every single day the past week, almost week and a half. Morning, Ellie. Beyond Meat up here. Serve's now down almost 3%. That's interesting. Yes, we are. It's very poignant commentary there, buddy. There's got to be a script to do that for me. Somewhere, somehow, there's got to be a script. PayPal, Micron. Okay, some of our leaders stalling out today. CRM, sort of a leader. We're not really that red though. Very minimal red numbers for the most part here. Take-Two Interactive, which that is not. All right, stuff was jumping around on me. IVR. A little buddy down here, a REIT. I wonder if the REITs are going to start coming back. Look how beaten down they are. This is one of the worst ones that, one of the more beaten down ones, I should say. I don't know about worse, but more beaten down. They get that dividend back, then. So it's a 5% dividend. So it's still about a 20% dividend yield if that's the case. Real estate stocks moving in Tuesday's pre-market session. So they've got quite a few. I hate that blue text. It's impossible to read on a black background. Yeah, it's pretty slow. NASDAQ looks like it's turning negative here. Morning, Rob. Buddy, IVR with an 11% up day. We'll see. Volume so far is pretty good. 1 million shares already traded, average is 11. Actually, three is already traded. Tilray didn't work out as well as my URL trade. Actually, my Tilray trade was going out to 2022, so it hasn't even started yet in reality. Would have been a great jump start, though. It hasn't moved very far. All right, well, nitpick me then, fine. But I'm not too mad. It didn't collapse on earnings. We're still above the prior low, so I'm not really mad at that. Buy Z dip, you could. If you're interested, I mean, you could. It didn't really collapse. I'm not sure if there was good or bad news. I know one thing I saw yesterday. They said the coronavirus wasn't hurting MJ sales. Price target raised from Stifel Nicolaus and lowered from another one. I just saw it. From benchmark, cut it benchmark, Stifel Nicolaus raising. Whatever any of that means, probably not a whole lot. Seems our losses are decelerating still, which is good. Sales beat estimates just a little bit. I mean, its action isn't too bad. It's actually bouncing up over the overnight lows, trying to play with them right now. See how it go. Ended up on net somehow, so we'll take a look at that one. Yesterday, nice day after earnings, and not too bad this morning so far, holding fairly steady. Hell yeah, Rob. There you go, buddy. Go buy yourself almost something at the dollar store. Right, so it's now down a full 3%. So 5 now in the 3% category. Some of our better ones too, ZXY, ZYXI, however you say that one, INMD, Ping, and now down in the 2% category. A few more in the red here. Although we're not that bad. DDoG almost up 18% now. Still super early in this one too. That's huge. Not sure about a 40% day on DDoG, but hey, you never know. That'd be kind of fun. Man, the volume today is really great. Manitowoc, the best of the rest today. Not a whole lot going on the chart, but quite a bit of volume on the down here. Of course, that's coronavirus volume. But not really going that low. Actually, a small little inverted head and shoulders down here. We looked at this a while ago and actually mentioned it's been in a downtrend for 1, 2 years, and then almost 2.5 years since it's May. So, 2 year downtrend. I don't know, we'll see if we're able to pop up, but I doubt it's going to be do it quickly. Stamina to walk manias for spells? I have no idea what you mean. Beyond Meat, still doing good, up 4% today. Yeah, it looks like it's broken. That is actually another long-term turnaround play right there. Meets the 6-month base requirement. Pretty good to go. Man, trying for it. Tesla's up here. BEP back with a pullback to 30, which it usually never does. This thing never gets pulled back. I haven't seen that in a while, actually. Of course, it's usually towards the middle of our list because it's kind of a REIT. Oh, Manitowoc. That is how it's probably Scandinavian or something. That's how it sounds, Manitowoc. MTW is the ticker. Take a gander. They sell those huge cranes that you see on construction sites. So Roku had earnings, didn't pop on them really, but we haven't sold off either. We're just kind of chilling here. Oh, there you go. Okay. Not that kind of nerd. Other kind of nerd, but not that kind of nerd. I'm familiar a bit with mana being used for spells, but that's about it. So Roku not too bad here. Maybe even a long-term turnaround candidate. Maybe. It's definitely met the 6-month requirement. Topped over here. Yeah, it's about 9 months old. Buy more NVIDIA. NVIDIA looks super good. Today is having a bit of a down day. Not much, though. 0.12%. Woohoo. If that's your pullback you get, sure, that could be it. Oh, look at our, we got some reds creeping into our greens now. It's not so hot. We have two now in 3% category. Still have six in 2% category or category? 2% range. Now none in 3% range. All right. We'll see how it goes. Yeah, I mean Nvidia, there's nothing really wrong with Nvidia. If you like it, get it. That's fine. I still think AMD looks super. Yesterday was great. Not quite a full-blown adult pocket pivot, kind of a baby pocket pivot, actually, a 5-day pocket pivot. But that was, 6 days of straight decreasing volume too. Not that that's necessarily a bad thing. If you look on the chart, that's kind of how we went sideways and now popping up. Could lead to a trend change. Hopefully we'll start going here in the into the latter stages of the week, playing with the trend line from the cup and handle. Technical buy point though is up here at 58.90, whatever. 58, 56, 58 or 59 bucks. 10 cents above this high over here would be your technical buy point. And they both have very similar intraday charts. Thoughts up on V? Seems laggard the past week, and should I ditch it for something? I don't think so. Not yet. I mean, we do have this trend line in play since the low. If it gets to the trend line, then I think you can probably start to, have some conversations. But I mean, Visa is a super. One of the best quality companies on the planet. So I don't know about a much more prolonged downtrend. But we'll see. I mean, if it really starts to break trend, there's a possibility you could try to take a 33% profit on Visa. But I mean, this is real one in reality that eventually is going to get to 500 bucks. Could take 4 or 5 years, but super, super good business. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be. All right. Even slowly moving stocks are now looking erratic and volatile. Do you think that's a sign that we are still in a correction? Well, we're not in a correction. We're in a bull market by definition, or an upward trending market. In years. Well, okay, maybe 500 is a little bit much, but I mean it will get there. Trust me. Trust me. It could take, I don't know, five is way up here. It'll probably do a couple shakeouts. Yeah, okay. Maybe not in a few years. It may take 10 years to get there, but anyway. Upward correction. Well, it's not an upward correction. It's an uptrending market. It's not an upward correction. It's not in a correction. Period. Hasn't been since our follow through day way back here in April 2nd. This has been a bull market for about 5 weeks. Bull market, 5 weeks. The same amount of time everyone's been thinking it's going to correct. So I guess I'll just wait until you think it's going to go up forever, and then I'll sell. 29.41. Visa reaches 500 per share. I rolled it back. Okay, you're right. I was getting too ambitious. Think they're doing bulk trash right now. Let me go see. Oh yeah, there they go. We have bulk trash in our neighborhood. I'm not sure if they have it in San Francisco or not, but they basically throw a bunch of stuff on the curb and they come by and pick it up with a bulldozer and a garbage truck is pretty cool. Yeah, there you go with the $500. Absolutely, Rob. Sounds good. All right, a few down 6%. Restoration of Hardware down 3% now. Not super bueno. Yeah, how was Parker? Yeah, it looks like it did. Looks like it did. Yeah, we got plenty in our 2% range now. All right, let's look for some pullback buys. Rob, that's fantastic. You guys slept in a tent. Do your cousins have a house on the river or something, or did you guys camp? I've never been. Yeah, it's a little warm for camping. My wife would die. I think she would absolutely sweat herself, and there would be nothing but sack of bones and dried skin by the morning. Kind of how she rolls. All right, a sea of red now on our actionable list. Global watch list TZA up a significant amount. Russell must not be doing too great here. Wow, the TZA is up a bunch. Yeah, quite a bit of red, that's for sure. All right, see if there's any possibles down here. All right, that's cool. Cool in the morning. Yeah, it stays hot. That's one thing about the desert. It stays hot till about 4 a.m. and it gets cool again. You're like, oh, this is great. Oh, it's so nice. Let's go. Okay, I guess we're done. MongoDB yesterday breaking a long-term turnaround trend line. We'll see how that works out with the market situation today, but it's actually one of the few that are basically flat. So it's got a little bit of bullishness, and it's not super bullish, but It's definitely breaking that trend line. GLD up 0.5%. See if that's going to get going, if the market's going to be a little bit choppy on us. Not so much, not yet at least. Still kind of same old, same old. AMC, how did it end up yesterday? Still don't know why Amazon would buy AMC. That's such a weird one. Maybe the only market they haven't penetrated yet is the popcorn market. $200 million last month. They should have just bought it on the open market and got like 30% share and then gone to AMC. It was on local cinema. Go to movies free with a Prime membership. Oh my God, I'll love Amazon forever. That'd be dope. We would view increased control over theatrical window through the acquisition of a large exhibitor and providing Amazon both an incremental earnings stream from its own films and a marketing vehicle to drive additional subscribers. Huh. Yeah, they ain't doing that. Amazon don't like us that much. There's still a money-grubbing behemoth. All right, Manitowoc gaining some ground in kind of a choppy session so far. Tesla's still up here, which is a little strange. I was wondering how they're gonna respond to Musk's whole tirade about opening the plant and going to from Alameda to Reno or elsewhere, and just all the whining he's been doing. Okay. Mongo back towards positive territory. Yeah, right, Rob? That's pretty interesting. You get more into Eli's camp, the higher it gets. I know, I'm getting more into profit, the higher it gets. That's all I know. I'm not in any camp. I'm in no camp. I'm in the camp of, oh, what's the market doing? Going up? Sweet, let's go with it. I just want chart rationales. That's all I want. I'm not really arguing, although I am. I'm not really arguing. I'm just saying, show me in the chart. I want to see it. I want to see the bet. I get it. I told you, I don't think we're going straight to all-time highs, even though it looks like we're going straight to all-time highs, you know? But the chart's telling me we're up here, so I don't got much to argue with the market. Short AMC. That's another thought, although you are at a resistance point. And unfortunately, it's already down a significant amount. It's down 14%. That's too tight or too wide for a stop loss. I don't know. I think there's better trades out there. You don't have to take every opportunity comes your way. I don't think I would trade that one. Yeah, volume is tremendous. That's a lot of selling pressure. Yeah, I don't know why. Amazon and AMC would be like, it's so weird. Yeah, right? What should we charge for popcorn? We could start at $1. What? That makes our profit margin 300%. That's outrageous. We're Amazon. Make it 32 cents. Then we're not minus 1%. That's more like it. That's the Amazon margins that we like. Our investors have come to expect us to run on sub digit margins. Just sub digit, yeah. They make money though. They're not poking fun, but they make some cash. Dude, their popcorn's the best. It's kind of hard to argue. It's super good. I should make a popcorn popping machine and like a whole refill system. Just a whole popcorn system and just sell it. That would just decimate the movie industry. And with each bag, I can sell us I could sell a bootleg DVD of the newest movie. Some So you hear everyone chewing around you, so a couple people walking in front of you during key scenes. Sounds legit. Sounds legit. Ring. Look at how tight ring is on the daily chart here. Super tight. What? You say red box and popcorn? That's amazing. I have a feeling there's like a whole generation of kids though that doesn't go to movies and doesn't even know about movie theater popcorn. I feel sorry for them and their pitiful, pitiful little lives. Yeah, apparently he is, Ellie. I was going to ignore it, but let's chastise Rob a little bit. All right, back to penny stocks. Oh, do they have a reverse stock split? They did. One for 8,000. And they're still dropping. Thanks for giving us more room to drop, Chesapeake Energy. I appreciate it. See? They got another tenfold to go before they have to reverse split again. One for 100. Holy bejesus. Oh, negative $852 per share. Dude, the ICs are the bomb. Love ICs. I gotta get the popcorn though. Really pisses me off when they mess up the popcorn. Like, really pisses me off. But I'm giving you motherfuckers $7 for popcorn. It better be great, but no, they're even chintzing on the popcorn these days. Last time I was there, it wasn't. Actually, last two times I was there, wasn't the best popcorn experience. I was there to see Frozen 3, Ellie, so there could have been some drugs. Usually not something I would go watch. Although the kids did watch the Frozen movies, and I think they were pretty good. D-Dog, 18%. Although I didn't see Frozen 2, I saw about half of Frozen 1. It was pretty good. Story's a little bit, eh. LVGO. With a gap up and a small consolidation, this could be nice on a little breakout. That one's not too bad. If it starts to roll, pop up. You can put that in your spank bank. Oh yeah, put this blue dress on. You know, the funny thing is, I thought this was weird. The movie's about Elsa, who's like a lady that can spit snow or something. But the whole damn movie's about her sister. I thought it was kind of weird. I'm like, really? She's not even the main character. Mark it down 0.12%. It's coming true. It's coming true. Oh God, dude, hold on. Oh gosh, even better than that. I should just have a YouTube clip up of Let It Go. And then hold on a second. I should just keep that. Rob, say something about CHK. Just do it. Just do it. Rob, I know you're there. Rob, your friends are telling you to do something. Do it. I'm keeping this up from now on. That's the best. Rob's curious about CHK. All right, this is what I think about that one. Oh, oh. You want a million views on YouTube? Let's do that. Your 4-year-old son is saying, "You got kids listening?" Oh, I cursed earlier. I'm sorry. It's the gift that keeps on giving. Right, Rob's kids. Whenever he's looking at CHK or anything that's under a dollar, just start singing that song. Oh, that's hilarious. I love it. You know what? You can't be there all the time. You gotta hire some people every once in a while. Your dad will give you candy if you tell sing Let It Go when he looks at a stock under a dollar. It's like, thanks, son. You just saved me. Soxel, what's Soxel doing? Declining volume, holding pretty good. Market 0.22%. So look at our big uns. Hexo, what's Hexo again? Hexo 50 cent. Oh yeah, so this particular chart you should. See, now I've got it down. I've just. Perfect. It's perfect. The a-hole is strong with this one. No, I know, Ellie. I know. I'm thinking about ways to do that. I'm thinking about a way. I got to maybe write an Electron app that just has various clips loaded in there. Oh, but yeah, could do a couple of buttons on my thing, dude. I would turn into the Jim Cramer of the internet. That would be awesome. Just talking garbage about, you know, everyone's stock picks or crypto picks. That'd be awesome. Rob, you're welcome. You don't, these moments don't last forever, Rob. They don't last forever. Actually, you know what? I saw a video yesterday that I will never forget. And Rob, you're welcome. Oh, they're gonna play an ad. I hate you. Here's your visual. I saw that. I'm like, what? Like, I've never asked that question. I've always assumed I knew what was in there. But now you have me questioning things, little girl. Now I'm questioning things. Dude, the great is just the ferocity of which she sang that and the enthusiasm. Oh, brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. How do I not have more views on this video with my with the butthole song coming up? Come on. That's what we're here for. You want a horrible song stuck in your head? Come to the Real Stocks, Real Crypto channel. Beautiful. All right, so we appear to be steadily chilling at about this much green and this much red. Still quite a bit of red, 6% for Zixi. Not a tremendous amount of volume this morning. Good enough, but you know. Space Restoration Hardware. Paze, Carvana, Lightgene, C Ping, any of these Bible that are down here today. Actually, I think it has to happen, Ellie. I think it has to happen. I have, you know, what would make the Let It Go song funnier is if you were singing it. Let it go. You'd almost sound like Dracula because the Ukrainian accent kind of sounds like Dracula. That would be hilarious, dude. You've just got to do it. Record it, send me a clip, and I'll go ahead and play it. Oh, they know where their cash is.
Man, Twitter just can't get it going. Just won't. Like, yeah, I know we got a stock, but no. Is Twitter on my actionable list? Every once in a while, Twitter ends up on my actionable list, but he's gonna end up UAL or AMD with a pullback. And we're back to positive territory ever so slightly. So pretty good. Holding, not so bad. Talk about parabolic. Look at ring on the weekly. My goodness. Straight up. Yeah, definitely kind of a more choppy day today. We're gonna pause the buying pressure, it seems. Thanks, Fed. I was hoping for a great May 12th, but no, you're gonna pause your buying. You're gonna let the market do what it actually wants to do, which is go sideways. What's wrong with you? Yeah, Beyond Meat, not too bad out of this long-term turnaround here. Yeah, Tesla, I know. It's too good, man. Tesla's just too good. You know what I did look up the other day? I didn't seem to find an answer, was if they had any kind of Bitcoin looking like froggy this morning. Battery Investor Day. See if they've done that yet. Tesla's tabless battery patent published prior to Battery Day. What's this? Ooh, is this what they're going to tell us on Battery Day? May 11th. This was yesterday. A new patent for battery storage and the contents are potentially very significant. Tesla's mission to produce long-range, lower-cost electric vehicles that will last as long as electric vehicle hosts. What? No way. A tabless electrode. Not sure what that means. Does away with the tabs that connect the positive and negative terminals of a jelly roll battery. Soon host a battery. They've been saying that forever. Oh, third week of May. Okay. Ooh, next week? Ooh. Ooh, yes. See, this is the kind of nerd I am. Head thermometers? Kind of. There's two ways I can interpret that, and I like both of them. One of the most exciting days in Tesla's history. We're just trying to figure out the right timing for that. Many types of battery cells are currently used as energy sources in electric vehicles. Use a jelly roll design in which the cathode, anode, and separators are rolled together and have a cathode tab and an anode tab to connect the positive and negative terminals of the cell. The path of the current necessarily travels through these tabs to connectors on the outside of the cell. However, ohmic resistance is increased with distance when current must travel all the way along the cathode or anode to the tab and out of the cell. Interesting. Furthermore, because the tabs are additional components, they increase cost and present manufacturing challenges. A tabless electrode negates the use of a tab. Now we're getting away from the patent. To make the positive negative connection. By instead using two substrates, one of which has a conductive edge. Interesting. Between the main portion of the substrate and the conductive edge, an insulating layer ensures that there's no electrical contact between the first substrate. The substrate containing the substrate coating and the conductive edge. It looks exactly like this advertisement. Electrical resistance of a given material is directly proportional to its length. In conventional electrochemical cell design, the electrode tab contact is typically fixed at either end or the middle of the wound electrode. In order to initiate an electrochemical reaction, the current must thus travel lengthwise the electrode to reach the active material where the charge transfer reactions take place. Interesting. I never thought of it that way. Is that why batteries fail? Because it's that little thing of copper going into the thing of lithium. Have any other pictures? No other pictures. All right, I want to see it. I can't see it. What? How are these images? Page 1 of 1. This is disturbing. Rob, I'm going to have to play Let It Go for you again. Three times the ETF, always going to have a bad week if the market's going down. Their next button or something? Come on, I'm geeking out over here on Tesla stuff for crying out loud. Okay, so how to get to the drawings? It didn't like it on images. This used to be easier. So they found a new way to charge the battery, which apparently makes it more chargier. Yes, tech copyright, chargier. How is this even images? How do I, in this way? Okay, so there is the original, and this is what they want to do. So they're eliminating the extra that's kind of what I thought it was going to look like. Wow, that's pretty dope. I barely know what I'm looking at. I think that's a complete paradigm shift. Oh, so they're going to roll it like that? Are they still going to make cells out of it? Ooh, now they're making Frisbees. Here's a Tesla Frisbee, ladies and gentlemen. What? Are they going to stack cells vertically like this? Or are they going to make it? They're going to make the cells in Frisbees. So they're basically stacking like 15 battery cells into one battery cell. That would be dope. Although I'm not sure how that would do for... You got to look at both things simultaneously, which I'm not going to try to do here with you guys. Provide first substrate with the first coating. Stack an inner separator on top of the first substrate. Provide a second substrate having a second coating disposed thereon. Stack the second substrate on top of the inner separator. stack an outer separator on top of the second substrate such that the first substrate, the inner separator, the second substrate, and the outer separator are stacked in successive manner. Roll the first substrate, the inner separator, the second substrate, and the outer separator about a central axis such that the first substrate is closest in position to the central axis. Oh. Man, working at Tesla must be such fun. That's super cool. Like, if you're a battery guy, I know Rob's got kids listening. I don't want to go too crazy, but yeah. If you're a battery guy, this is like, got to be absolutely crazy. Due to the reduced electrical resistance, obviously, because you're switching electrons from different components of metals, we can expect electromechanical cells. We expect electromechanical cells of the present disclosure to generate significantly less ohmic heat compared to the cells of traditional tab design. That's so cool. Wait for these batteries. Holy bejesus. So these are the images. That's so awesome. I can't wait. So what they posted was a picture of the old design. That's what they posted because they're weird. So reducing resistance 5 to 20 times is huge, absolutely huge. Should make it charge faster, much faster, much faster. Yeah, if you're reducing resistance, you're reducing heat. Extends lifespan. That's awesome. Well, it'll increase charging time by probably, I don't know, 2 to 3 times, I'm thinking. I'm not an electrical engineer, but I do dabble. I used to be a low voltage tech for a long time, have to deal with wires and not really, you know, that deep into the thing, but having to calculate ohm loads and thinking about resistance levels and how it affects charging and things like that. We did a little bit of that. So for instance, like when I was doing car audio, you'd have batteries and you have capacitors. Well, a capacitor's ohm load is significantly less than a battery's ohm load, and it would charge and discharge extremely quickly. You've heard of a supercapacitor, right? Well, I can't say this is like a supercapacitor, but it's definitely going, it should decrease charging time. So if, I'm not sure what it takes to charge a Tesla now, like 4 hours or something. And keep in mind, it's probably only due to heat and resistance. When Tesla, they have like a 440 volt thing. They were actually engineering the jacket of the charging cable with cooling fluid. If you don't need that cooling fluid, then you can do that natively with that same type of thing, but on the battery side. Supercharges are 30 minutes, but it's like an 80% charge to get that last little bit. Anyway, like I said, I'm not an electrical engineer. I know enough to be dangerous, but that's pretty significant. If your ohm load goes from, I don't know what their ohm loads are on the charging side, but yeah, reducing this little capacitor, this little nub there. So they're just doing, yeah, that's interesting. It's fantastic. Gotta love being an electrical engineer working at Tesla. That's all I'm going to say. So it looks like battery day in about a week and a half, 2 weeks. That's awesome. The geek in me has been waiting for that one for a long time. Oh, D-Dog is at 20% now. All right. I was waiting for that. Not that I'm doing anything about it, but I was kind of thinking it would hit. LVGO breaking a range. Breaking a range on the way up. Green volume stepping in a Tilray? Is there green volume stepping in a Tilray? Yeah, well, green volume's good. Green volume's good. We just gotta wait it out. I mean, look, it's not rip-roaring higher. There's obviously not a mad rush to get into the stock. The thing may not work at all. You know, we talked about... Yeah, so I took a small position on Tilray. Just a small one again with a larger price. If it has a general large trend shift, you know, it's going to be a very good risk to reward trade from down here. So that's kind of what I'm looking at. I'm looking at that bigger picture. If we just completely fail this base, I'm out. I'm out. And I may not get much back cuz it's an option, but it's like I said, it's a very small position. The risk reward on this one is pretty favorable, and it's up to 2022. So, not that that means anything. Our MJ options were out to 2021. Look how that worked out. So, but I'm not making the same mistake. I went decently heavy into that trade, and I got hurt. I'm still looking at it today. They're still sitting in my account, right there, reminding me not to do stupid stuff. But I don't mind cheap stupid stuff. Gene, see down another five. More greens creeping in the market here. And we're up almost 0.2%. Not too shabby. So yeah, I don't mind Tilray. I think you have to have a bit of a longer term perspective on it though. We'll see. There's quite a bit of... The MJ story is not done by a long shot, up or down. But we could hang out down here sub 15 for ever. If it really needed to. All right, Beyond Meat up 3%. Tesla 2.76. Someone heard me talking about the batteries, and so they bought a bunch of them. I may end up getting, if they put them in the power wall, I may end up getting a power wall if my solar panels ever start working again. LVGO, VGO, will you go up some more? You probably will. Sorry. I apologize to everyone out there. Soxel, 1.29%. Weren't they down earlier? They were. Coming back with the market. RH coming back too. A little bit. Little bit. IVR pulling back. Beyond Meat still holding good too. MongoDB looks like extending up today. All right. Been a little bit of a laggard, but did go down too far. 88%. That's not right. That's definitely not right. All right, cool. D-Dog, 22%. This thing's going today, man. Look at that. Straight up off that bottom. They wanted it, but apparently it took them a while to realize it. And now that they have earnings, they like something. Let's see what the earnings were with D-Dog. Price target of 59. We're well above that. To 66 from 46. Another analyst. Let's see how do analysts make money? I see Mount Long and D-Dog at the open. Looks like I should have. I may try plays like that for some of these story stocks. D-Dog up. 0.3 for the NASDAQ. Well, that was our pullback, I guess. I think that the Fed found their money. ZYXI down 7% today. Maybe a buying opportunity. 7% seems pretty significant. How's our volume doing? Oh, it's pretty good. So they already had earnings. That kind of sparked this whole thing a little bit. ZYXI, what do they do again? Let's go see. Medical devices. Oh, these are the guys that do the tens machines, right? You you clog your site with stuff like this. Never stops loading. All right, guys, I think I'm going to get out of here. Market seems to have recovered pretty nicely. We weren't really that hurt to begin with. A few names really taken up. ZYXI looks like trying to come off a low here intraday. Could be an interesting buying opportunity for that one. Kind of thinking about it, actually. We'll see how it goes. Restoration Hardware trying to come back. So, all right, guys, well, have a good day. I will see you.